اللهم صل على محمد وعلى أزواجه وذريته كما صليت على آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمد وعلى أزواجه وذريته كما باركت على آل إبراهيم، إنك حميد مجيد. إن شاء الله we are doing the final section or chapter of the book Our Need to the Sunnah, حاجتنا إلى السنة, which was collected by the Sheikh Dr. محمد بن عبد الرحمن المغراوي حفظه الله تعالى. This is the last section and it's quite a little bit long, so it will take us two or three sessions inshallah to cover the information in it. And this chapter is titled بيان شرف أصحاب الحديث والمعتنين بسنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عامة, clarifying the nobility, the excellence, the high status of the people of hadith and those who take care of the sunnah in general, the sunnah of the messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam in general. He quotes, starts by quoting from the book authored by al-imam at-tirmidhi alayhi rahmatullah, his sunan, his jami', the book of knowledge. And he mentions the chain and he says that, the narrator says that Zayd ibn Thabit radiyallahu anhu, he came out from Marwan. Marwan was the ruler then, at the midday, nisf al-nahar. So they asked him, they asked Zayd radiyallahu anhu, they said about Zayd that this ruler did not send to Zayd except for something that he asked him about. So this is, they figured out this ruler, he calls Zayd to come radiyallahu anhu, it must be something that he asked him about. That's what they thought. So he said, we asked him, did he ask you about anything? And the answer was yes. He said, he asked me about things that we heard from the messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He said, سَمِعْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. He narrates to them now what he narrated to Marwan. He said, I heard the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, نَضَّرَ اللَّهُ امْرَأً سَمِعَ مِنَّا حَدِيثًا فَحَفِظَهُ حَتَّى يُبَلِّغَهُ غَيْرَهُ فَرُبَّ حَامِلِ فِقْهٍ إِلَى مَنْ هُوَ أَفْقَهُ مِنْهُ وَرُبَّ حَامِلِ فِقْهٍ لَيْسَ بِفَقِيهٍ. This is in the Sunan of At-Tirmidhi. It's an authentic hadith. It says, I heard the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, may Allah beautify the face of one who heard from us a hadith, who heard from us a statement. So he memorized it up until he delivered it to other than himself. For how many of a carrier of fiqh, carrier of jurisprudence or understanding, to someone who has more understanding than him? And how many of a carrier of fiqh, a carrier of understanding or jurisprudence, who is not, how many of a carrier of fiqh who is not a faqih, who is not a jurist? Carrier of fiqh here, meaning carrier of a hadith. يعني the hadith of the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, the statements of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, is the true understanding of the religion. For what is the religion other than Quran and hadith? So رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم says, نضر الله امرأ. النضرة or نضارة is when the face looks good and beautiful because it's being, you know, looked after. The body of that person is being in an enjoyment, you know, like about the people of paradise, تَعْرِفُ فِي وُجُوهِهِمْ نَضْرَةَ النَّعِيمِ. You know, the one who is being well fed, well taken care of, you find, you know, the face puffing up, you know, coming out and looks shiny, while the one who is in a miserable situation, you find his face, you know, looks gloomy and miserable and sad, right? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam makes dua for the one who narrates the hadith now. He makes dua for him, for his face to be beautiful. Who? The one who heard from us a statement, he memorized it until he delivered it to other than himself. For how many of a carrier of understanding the hadith, carrier of a hadith, that is, he carries it to someone who has more understanding than him. He comprehends him more than himself. And how many of a carrier of fiqh, carrier of a hadith, that is, who is not a faqih, who is not really a jurist, who doesn't really understand it deeply. Although he knows it, he memorizes it, but he does not, you know, fully comprehend it. So when he conveys it to the others, those other people, you might find amongst them those who, yani mashallah, they listen to the statement, they derive from it hundreds of rulings. When the narrator himself, he goes like, where did you get all of this? And he says, from the hadith that you narrated to me, because he understands better than him, right? But then, both, they are, yani even the one who just conveys the message, he memorizes it, he conveys it as he heard it, Rasulullah ﷺ makes dua for him too. Because he carries it to someone who will understand it better than him, he may, right? Or he may carry it, but he does not fully comprehend it. But when he conveys it, then others will, yani the rulings of the Sharia will be spread. طيب. Now he mentions, yani now Imam al-Tirmidhi mentions more than one route, and there is a little bit difference in the wording. So the next one, it says, he mentions the chain and all of that, and he says that yani the same hadith, there are narrations that are like it from different sahaba, Abdullah bin Mas'ud, Mu'adh bin Jabal, Jubair bin Mut'im, Abi Darda, Anas, right, and so on. Then he mentions another route, yani the hadith of Abdullah bin Mas'ud. He says yani that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, نظر الله امرأ سمع منا شيئا فبلغه كما سمع فرب مبلغ أوعى من سامع. Almost the same meaning. May Allah beautify the face of the person who heard from us something and he delivered it as he heard it. For how many of a deliverer, how many how many of a person who received مبلغ, the one who received the delivery, right? How many of a person who receives, who has more comprehension, more understanding than the one who heard it, than the one who heard it. And if someone might not be there, but then he gets the hadith from someone else and he understands it better. He mentions another narration. Also Abdurrahman ibn Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he narrates from his father Abdullah, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. It says, also, it is this. This is authentic. Also, it says, "نظر الله امرأ سمع مقالتي فوعاها وحفظها وبلغها." May Allah beautify the face of a person who heard my statement, so he understood it, he memorized it, and he delivered it. فرب حامل فقه إلى من هو أفقه منه. For how many of a carrier of fiqh, carrier of understanding, carrier of a hadith, to someone who understands it better than him. Then there is an addition in this hadith. It's an authentic narration also. He said, ثَلَاثٌ لَا يَغِلُّ عَلَيْهِنَّ قَلْبُ مُسْلِمٍ. Three matters that will not leave any evil substances in the heart of a Muslim. يعني grudges and envy and filthy materials in the heart. And those three matters, if the Muslim, these three qualities, if the Muslim acts upon them, those three qualities will serve to clean up and cleanse his heart from all evils. What are they? It says, إخلاص العمل لله. Doing actions, doing deeds, sincerely for the sake of Allah, seeking the face of Allah alone. ومناصحة أئمة المسلمين. And to advise the Muslim imams, the Muslim leaders. ولزوم جماعتهم, and to stick to the group, stick to the Muslim group, stick to the jama'ah, not be disunited and like that, stick to the jama'ah, the truth. فإن الدعوة تحيط من وراءهم. For the dua, the call, their call, the call of the Muslims, it will engulf those who are around them or behind them, right? So when you are with the jama'ah, they make dua, you get a share of that call. As long as you stick to it and don't split it. Don't split it by going against the ruler, or don't split it by going against the truth and following innovations and heresies, bid'ah and dalalat, right? So these three qualities, if the Muslim sticks to and acts upon, they will serve to cleanse and purify his heart from all evil substances. Doing deeds sincerely for the sake of Allah, and offering advice to the people of authority, the scholars and the leaders, and to also stick to the group of Muslims. If the Muslims are together behind one leader, don't split them up, don't revolt and cause chaos between the Muslims. And also, the Muslims, their jama'ah is upon the haqq, upon the truth, upon the sunnah. Do not split, do not bring bid'ah, innovations and heresies. This hadith is what they call mutawatir. Mutawatir, that is narrated by so many companions, so many of the companions, right? In a way that it cannot be a lie. A large group of narrators narrate the hadith, and in a way that it cannot be a lie. You know, they are talking about something they heard or seen, right? And it cannot be a lie. This, the da'wah, the Shaykh Al-Maghrawi Hafidhahullah, he said this is a blessed du'a. This is a blessed du'a, da'watun mubarakah. And it will reach, it will cover, inshallah, it will reach everyone who acts upon, everyone who does what he can to spread the sunnah. كل من قام بنشر السنة. Anyone who works towards spreading the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, inshallah, this du'a of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to make his face beautiful and brilliant, right? To make it good, then he is covered with this du'a of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now he mentions the ways. He said, either he spreads the sunnah by his pen writing, like the Shaykh writing this book. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala beautify his face. And all of these narrators and all of these quotes from these books, may Allah beautify their faces all. Also, وَبِي خِطَابِهِ, by speaking to the people, spreading the sunnah by speaking. وَبِي دَعْوَتِهِ, by calling the people to follow the sunnah. وَبِي طَلَبَتِهِ, by having students who will spread the sunnah. وَبِمَدَارِسِهِ, by the schools that one will establish to spread and teach the sunnah. وَبِأُسْرَتِهِ, by his family members, teaching them so that they will teach and spread the sunnah. وَبِمَالِهِ, spending in this cause to spread the sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. وَبِهِمَّتِهِ, by his ambitions and aspirations, by his willpower to spread the sunnah. وبوساطته, by him being a medium, by him being an intercessor, you know, making things work so the sunnah will be spread. You know, someone asks you, he wants to go and study the sunnah, please recommend me to that school, recommend me to the university, recommend me to, so you do that recommendation, you make a phone call, please accept this student, and the likes of that. بوساطة. Or you call the print shop and tell them, print this book for him, this is a good book, right? By you being serving as an intermediary, basically to help spread the sunnah. وَبِذَهَابِهِ وَبِإِيَابِهِ, by going, by him going and by him coming back. وَبِتَفْكِيرِهِ, thinking, finding ways to spread the sunnah. وَبِتَخْطِيطِهِ, by planning to spread the sunnah. وَبِكُلِّ مَا يَمْلِكُهُ مِنْ مُقَوِّمَاتِ لِنَشْرِ سُنَّةِ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, and by anything or everything that one has, any type of means that he will do in order to spread the sunnah. All of these are, inshallah, covered, and they go under the dua of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam to beautify the face of the one who spreads his sunnah. He quotes from Al-Allama Al-Qari. He said that the one who spreads, the one who delivers, مبلغ, the one who delivers the hadith of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, exactly like he heard it, exactly like he heard it, he was given this special and specific dua from the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. That is because this person who delivers the hadith of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم exactly like he heard it, he is working hard, he is striving to make the knowledge fresh and brilliant, you know, to make it revived, right? To make the sunnah revived, so therefore, or renewed, yani spread and renewed between the people. So then he was rewarded by this beautiful dua, this nice dua, because it is suitable to his condition. He's trying to put the life and make the sunnah be spread and be revived within the people. So Allah Azza wa Jal put this life in him and makes his face look good. And this proves the nobility of hadith and its excellence and the degree and the high degree and level of those who seek the hadith. Since Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam here, he made a dua especially for them, for the seekers of hadith, for the deliverers of hadith, and he did not include others in this dua. He did not include others of the ummah in this dua to make their face beautiful. This is special for the people who deliver the hadith exactly as they heard it. He said that if there is nothing, yani no benefit, if there is no benefit in seeking the knowledge of hadith and memorizing it and delivering it to others, if there is no benefit other than benefiting this barakah, this blessing of this blessed dua, then this is enough for a benefit, this is enough for an achievement, and it is something that one will achieve yani a great deal in both lives, in both worlds, this world and the next life. He will get an excellent share of khayr or good deeds. He quotes from Al-Qadi Abu Bakr Ibn Al-Arabi. This is one of the well-known Maliki scholars. He said that the scholars of hadith, they said that there is no man who seeks the hadith, who seeks to learn the hadith and to learn it, memorize it, and then spread it. There is no man who seeks the hadith, the knowledge of hadith, except that you will find on his face brilliance. You will find on his face some beauty, nudra. That is because of the statement of the Prophet ﷺ, this statement. May Allah beautify the face of the one who heard my statement and understood it, and then he delivered it as he heard it. He said, and this is a dua from him, alayhi salatu wasalam, to those who will carry his knowledge. And they must, by the excellence of Allah Azza wa Jal, by the bounty of Allah Azza wa Jal in his favor, they must attain the blessing, the barakah of this dua of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam. So he said that there is no one who seeks to learn the hadith and to deliver it except that you will find some sort of goodness or brilliance, beauty on his face because of that. And he mentions a line of poetry. He said that this brilliance or this beauty, the scholar by the name of Abu al-Abbas al-Azfi, he said in a line of poetry, Ahlul Hadithi Isabatul Haqqi. The people of Hadith, they are the group of truth. فازوا بدعوة سيد الخلق. They succeeded in attaining the dua of the master, the leader of the created beings. فوجوههم زهر منبرة لألاؤها كتألق البرق. So their faces are brilliant and are beautiful, and the shiny, yani the shine of these faces, they are so shiny, they look like how the lightning is so shiny. لألاؤها كتألق البرق. He said, يا ليتني معهم فيدركني ما أدركوه بها من السبق. I wish I was with them, so I will catch some of what they caught of, you know, pioneering in this field. Pioneering in this field. And I believe, inshallah, and it was difficult to find his biography, but I found on the internet. He was from the scholars of hadith himself. This one who is hoping to get some, he was from them. Inshallah, he was from them. So, أهلُ الحديثِ عصابةُ الحقِّ فازوا بدعوة سيد الخلق فوجوههم زهر منضرة لألاؤها كتألق البرق يا ليتني معهم فيدركني ما أدركوه بها من السبق. Now he says in this line of poetry, he's just basically emphasizing the fact that they attained the beauty because they were you know, from the people who carried the hadith to others, and therefore they attained the dua from the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. That was quotations from the book titled Tuhfat al-Ahwadi, Tuhfat al-Ahwadi, the explanation of the Sunan of Imam al-Tirmidhi by the great scholar from India, Al-Mubarak Furi, rahimahullah. Also, he quotes from the same book by Al-Mubarak Furi, Tuhfat al-Ahwadi, and he quotes from Al-Imam al-Bayhaqi, and he mentions the chain that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يَحْمِلُ هَذَا الْعِلْمِ من كل خلف عدوله ينفون عنه تحريف الغالين وانتحال المبطلين وتأويل الجاهلين. This is also an authentic hadith. He said عليه الصلاة والسلام that there will carry this knowledge, the knowledge of hadith that is, there will carry this knowledge from every succeeding generation the just and trustworthy amongst them. They will negate from it the twisting, the alteration of those who went to the extremes. And they will also negate from it the claims, yani, of the people of falsehood, those who are imposters, basically. They claim the knowledge of hadith and they don't know it, right? So there will be scholars who are just and trustworthy in every generation, every succeeding generation, who will do this. They will, yani, exterminate the twisting and the alteration of those who go into extremes, those who go overboard, ghalin, and they will also exterminate the claims of the people of falsehood. And they will also exterminate the explanation of the ignorant ones, of the ignorant ones. Now, there are a number of narrators that narrated this hadith from the Sahaba. He mentions them, and inshallah, this is an authentic hadith. And it says here that in this hadith there is now a special quality, a special and great quality for the people of hadith, حملت السنة. And he is quoting from Al-Qistalani. يعني, there is a special quality for the people of hadith, that there is a high quality for them here. And also in this hadith there is giving excellence and magnifying the status and the level of the Ummah of Muhammad alayhi as-salatu was-salam. It clarifies the high ranking or level of the Muhaddithin, the people of Hadith, and how the fact that their level is very high within mankind, that is because they are the ones who protect the Sharia, and they are the ones who protect the texts of the hadith, the wordings of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from the twisting of those who go into extremes, from the explanation of those who are ignorant. And they do this, they protect the Sharia by reporting the texts that are muhkama, that are crystal clear, that will refute the misunderstandings that those ignorant people will do to the hadith. So the true people of hadith, they will explain it the right explanation. They will bring the reports from the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that will put things in order, that will save the correct understanding of the hadith. Al-Imam al-Nawawi, in the beginning of his book called At-Tahdhib, fi tahdhibih, he said that this is a report from him alayhi salatu wasalam bi siyanati hadha al-ilm. This is a report from the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasalam that this knowledge, the knowledge of hadith, will be protected and will be preserved, and that the carriers of the hadith, they are just and trustworthy. Adalatu naqilih. And that Allah Azza wa Jal facilitates in every era, in every generation, Allah will facilitate successors, khulafa, min al-udul, successors who are just and trustworthy. They will carry it and they will take away from it. They will distinguish the truth from falsehood. They will terminate the twisting, the misunderstandings. So the hadith will not be lost. It will not be lost. And this, Al-Imam al-Nawawi says, in this hadith, there is tasrih. It explicitly mentions that the carriers of hadith, the narrators of hadith, Ahlul Hadith, they are udul. They are just and trustworthy in every era, in every time, in every generation. Once again, the hadith, it says, يحمل هذا العلم من كل خلف عدوله, that there will carry this knowledge of hadith from every generation its just and trustworthy people. They will succeed one another. In every era there are people, and then the next one will have successors succeeding them that will take the banner, and they will also do the same job. Al-Imam al-Nawawi alayhi rahmatullah, he said, وَهَكَذَا وَقَعْ وَالْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ. This is the way it happened, and all praise is due to Allah. وَهُوَ مِنْ أَعْلَامِ النُّبُوَّةِ. And this is also one of the signs of the true prophethood of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he foretold this and it happened. And he said, وَلَا يَضُرْ كَوْنُ بَعْضِ الْفُسَّاقِ يَعْرِفُ شَيْئًا مِنْ عِلْمِ الْحَدِيثِ. Someone might say, some of the wicked people, the untrustworthy ones, they know some knowledge of hadith. He said the fact that there are people like this who know some hadith, this does not harm this information that was given, right? That every generation will have just and trustworthy. Because the hadith, it says that this hadith says, informs, that there will be udul, there will be just and trustworthy carrying it. It does not say that other than those, nobody knows anything about it. It does not say that. So there could be others who share that. And this is a fact, unfortunately. You will find people who know some hadith, and they know the narrators, and they know the chains, and but they are completely immersed in their madhabs, blind following their madhabs. And they use their knowledge of the men of hadith and the narrators to support their madhab, to strengthen the weak ahadith that their madhabs are upon, and to refute the crystal clear authentic ahadith that they know for sure they are there. But then it's just they are sharing this knowledge of hadith, but they are not from the trustworthy ones. But this is a statement from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It is a sign that he is a true messenger of Allah, alayhi salatu wasalam, because he foretold that in every generation there will be people who protect the hadith and refute those people of falsehood in their different ways of twisting and falsifying and making false claims about hadith. There will always be, and alhamdulillah, there was. Then he goes on to say, we could also say that the fact that some wicked people, some fussaq, the fact that they know some knowledge, this is not real knowledge. ليس بعلم يعني حقيقة. That is, it's not real knowledge because they do not act upon it. Like, you know, it could be said that the one who is knowledgeable, he might have, unfortunately, the same status as an ignorant. You know, يعني, and I said, and I keep saying, you find someone, he learned from his mother or his father something about wudu or about salah, and he grows up and goes into يعني Islamic knowledge, and he learns and he goes up to, you know, those degrees that they give nowadays. He might have the highest degrees, and the way he prays is just like what his ignorant mother taught him. And if you ask him, he will tell you, yeah, this is in Bukhari, that's in Muslim, that's يعني, he memorizes and he knows, but يعني, knowledge that does not benefit, knowledge that does not benefit, very unfortunately. He said that Al-Imam al-Shafi'i explicitly mentioned this, saying in a line of poetry, وَلَا الْعِلْمُ إِلَّا مَعَ التُّقَى وَلَا الْعَقْلُ إِلَّا مَعَ الْأَدَبُ. Right? يعني, he said, knowledge cannot be except if it is coupled with taqwa, piety. And you have knowledge and you have piety together. If there is knowledge without piety, then that knowledge is not يعني, beneficial. Also, عقل, يعني having sound intellect and sound mind, it cannot, you will not find it except with good manners, right? Good manners. If someone doesn't have good manners, hardly you find him to be a wise man. He would be someone who's foolish, not a wise man. Then he goes on saying that this affair of, you know, learning and spreading the hadith is one of the strongest parts of the religion and one of the strongest handhold of certainty. أوثق عرى اليقين. He said, and no one who longs and yearns to spread the hadith except someone who is صادق and تقي, someone who is truthful, someone who is pious. ولا يزهده إلا كل منافق شقي. No one who has zuhud, asceticism, or being aloof, or doesn't care about it, doesn't give any care to it, except someone who is a hypocrite, someone who is a sad person or wretched person. And he quotes from Al-Imam Ibn Al-Qattan عليه رحمة الله that he said, ليس في الدنيا مبتدع إلا وهو يبغض أهل الحديث. There is no innovator, heretic or deviant in this dunya, in this worldly life, except that he must be someone who hates the people of hadith, the people who narrate the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And Al-Imam Al-Hakim, he also said, were it not for the abundance or the abundant number of the group of muhaddithin, يعني the group of narrators of hadith, were it not for their abundance in number, يعني they protected the chains of narrators, then يعني the minaret of Islam would have vanished. يعني the people of hadith, they are the ones Allah Azza wa Jal facilitated them for the ummah to preserve and to save the knowledge of Islam. And you will find the people of disbelief, people of innovation, they will be able to fabricate hadith. They will fabricate hadith and introduce their own hadith and claim that these are the hadith of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. And they will be also those innovators and those people of ilhad, people of deviance. They will flip the chains, you know, they will flip the chains of the narrators, they will mix them up. But then when they did that, the scholars of hadith, they were right there, you know, on guard, fixing them, fixing those chains and refuting those innovators. Al-Imam al-Tirmidhi, alayhi rahmatullah, he also mentions in his book, Kitab al-Fitan, Sunan al-Tirmidhi, Kitab al-Fitan, he mentions the chain that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إذا فسد أهل الشام فلا خير فيكم. If the people of Sham become corrupt, then there is no good in you at all. Then he said, لا تزال طائفة من أمتي منصورين لا يضرهم من خذلهم حتى تأتي الساعة. He said that there will continue a group of my ummah who are victorious. They will not be harmed by those who let them down up until the hour comes, up until the hour is established. And Imam al-Tirmidhi says, قال محمد بن إسماعيل, that Muhammad ibn Ismail, this is an Imam al-Bukhari, said, قال علي بن المديني, that this other scholar of hadith said, هم أصحاب الحديث. They are the people of hadith. Those people in the hadith, that they will continue to be a group who are victorious. They will not be harmed by those who let them down. He said, Imam al-Tirmidhi quotes from, says from Bukhari, that Ali ibn al-Madini said, they are the people of hadith. Abu Isa, he mentions, al-Tirmidhi alayhi rahmatullah, he mentions the other narrators who narrate something similar. And this is an authentic hadith. And al-Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah, in his sahih, he said, Bab, and he put a section there, the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لا تزال طائفة من أمتي ظاهرين على الحق وهم أهل العلم. He said that this section, the chapter or the title of that book, he said that the statement of the messenger, of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there will continue to be a group of my ummah who are victorious, who are apparently upon the truth, right? Who are manifest upon the truth. He said, وَهُمْ أَهْلُ الْعِلْمِ. Imam Bukhari said, and they are the people of knowledge. They are the people of knowledge. He mentions the chain, and he mentions the hadith, لَا تَزَال, they will continue a group of my ummah who are victorious, who are triumphant, ظاهرين, up until the affair of Allah comes, while they are upon victory. Well, they are victorious, ظاهرون, they are apparent. They are apparently upon the truth. They are triumphant. He mentions also the chain, and he says, the hadith says, I heard, يعني معاوية, this is the hadith of معاوية بن أبي سفيان, that he was giving a speech, and he said, I heard the messenger, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم say, من يريد الله به خيرا يفقهه في الدين. The one whom Allah wants good for him, he will make him knowledgeable in the religion. وَإِنَّمَا أَنَا قَاسِمٌ وَيُعْطِي اللَّهِ. And I am only a distributor. And the one who gives is Allah. Allah is the one who grants. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم distributes what Allah assigns. وَلَنْ يَزَالَ أَمْرُ هَذِهِ الْأُمَّةِ مُسْتَقِيمًا حَتَّى تَقُومَ السَّاعَةِ أَوْ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ أَمْرُ اللَّهِ. And the affair of this ummah will continue to be straight, will continue to be steadfast up until the hour is established, or up until the affair of Allah comes. This is in the Sahih of Al-Imam Al-Bukhari. And Al-Imam Al-Hakim, he narrated in his book Ulum Al-Hadith, the Sciences of Hadith, with an authentic chain from Imam Ahmad, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal alayhi rahmatullah, that he said, إِن لَمْ يَكُونُوا أَهْلَ الْحَدِيثِ فَلَا أَدْرِي مَنْ هُمْ. He said, if they are not the people of hadith, then I do not know who they are. يعني those people who are victorious, who are triumphant, who will continue to be victorious upon the truth, upon steadfastness, they will not be harmed by those who let them down. He said, if they are not the people of hadith, the people who narrate the sunnah and spread the sunnah of the messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then I do not know who they are. And also from the route of Yazid ibn Harun, the likeness of that, the same statement. Now he will quote some lines of poetry from the book titled Tuhfa, Tuhfat al-Ahwazi. This is the book by the scholar from India, Al-Mubarak Furi. He explained Sunan al-Tirmidhi, and before starting the explanation, he put a big introduction to it. about the excellence of hadith, the excellence of its people, the different types of books and the titles of the scholars of hadith and like that. And along with that, he mentioned some lines of poetry. So At-Tirmidhi, Imam Al-Mubarak Furi, he said in At-Tuhfa, and that the people of knowledge, he said, they mentioned regarding the excellence of hadith and its people, they have a lot of statements. A lot of statements that are in poetry form and a lot of statements that are not poetry, like composition type of style. So he mentions some of the lines of poetry. Inshallah, I will try my best to go through this and try to translate it, you know, as much as I could. There were some printing mistakes and like that, so it was a bit difficult to go through it, but I will try to do my best. He says, he quotes from one poet, Al-Murtada Al-Hussein. He said, عليك بأصحاب الحديث فإنهم خيار عباد الله في كل محفل. He said, stick to, I counsel you to stay with the people of hadith, stick to them, for they are the best of the servants of Allah in every gathering. وَلَا تَعْدُوَنْ عَيْنَاكَ عَنْهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ نُجُومُ الْهُدَى فِي أَعْيُنِ الْمُتَأَمِّلِ. And do not let your eyes, you know, surpass them, right? For surely they are the stars of guidance in the eyes of the one who really examines and considers. جَهَابِذَةٌ ثُمَّ سُرَاتٌ فَمَنْ أَتَى إِلَىٰ حَيِّهِمْ يَوْمًا فَبِالنُّورِ يَمْتَلِي. They are people who are firmly grounded in knowledge. And they are classy. You know, they are from the noble people. So the one who comes to their area, one day, then he will be filled with light. He will be filled with light. لَقَدْ شَرَقَتْ شَمْسُ الْهُدَى فِي وُجُوهِهِمْ وَقَدْرُهُمُ فِي النَّاسِ لَا زَالَ يَعْتَلِي. He said that the sun of guidance has risen in their faces, has risen on their faces, and their status in the people continues to go up and up. Their status, they are still rising up in status. فَلِلَّهِ مَحْيَاهُمْ مَعًا وَمَمَاتُهُمْ لَقَدْ ظَفَرُوا إِدْرَاكَ مَجْدٍ مُؤَثَّلِي. He said, how great they are when they are alive and when they are dead. When they are alive, they are narrating. When they are dead, the people who learned from them, they still carry their knowledge. Yani they are alive or they are dead, they are still benefiting. And we are, look at these, all of these narrations that we are getting, starting from the companions, radiallahu anhum. And it's starting from the companions. And we mentioned last time Abu Huraira, the different ahadith about him, radiallahu anhu, and how he was so careful to spread the hadith. And then that brilliant question that he asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam praised him for that question. When he said to him, who is going to be the happiest in terms of receiving your shafa'ah on the Day of Judgment? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, I thought that no one will ask you, no one will ask me this question, this hadith, more or better than you or before you. Yani no one will outrace you in this, right? Because of what I have seen of your diligence, of your carefulness in terms of hadith. Because he saw that he has a lot of, you know, passion for hadith. He said, yani this excellent question, it has to come from someone like you. No one asked this question. Yani it shows the excellence and the special excellence of the seekers of hadith, and that Allah Azza wa Jal facilitates for them excellences and good things that they are not facilitated to others. So he said, yani, he's wondering, he's amazed at them when they are alive and when they are dead. They are great in both cases. They have attained glory that is everlasting. Right, that is established. He said, وقال الإمام الشافعي مقالة غدت منهم فخرا لكل محصل. Imam Shafi'i, he said statement about them, about the people of hadith. And he was himself a man of hadith. Imam Shafi'i, he said about the people of hadith, he made a statement. He made a statement that became a source of glory, a source of pride for those who attained the knowledge of hadith. What is the statement? He said, and he put it in line of poetry, of course, it's not the same wording, but the meaning, he put it in the line of poetry. What did Imam Shafi'i say? The meaning of, أرى المرأة من أهل الحديث كأنه رأى المرأة من صحب النبي المفضلي. He said, I view the one who is from the people of hadith, I view him to be as if he is someone who met the person of the companions of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the companions of the Prophet who is given excellence. Right? So the narrator of hadith is as if he was with the companions radiallahu anhum. And it will come next week inshallah another line of poetry that says that the people of hadith they are although they did not accompany the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they accompanied his breaths that he was taking. They know everything about him alayhi salatu wasalam, right? They did not accompany him physically, but they accompanied all what he used to do and say and all of that. So they are really as if they are people who accompanied the companions, radiallahu anhum. This will come next week, inshallah. So I view the man from the people of hadith as if he is from the people who have seen the Prophet who is given excellence, alayhi salatullah. May Allah say salat or send salat upon him all the time and on his family and the companions, the people of excellence. Another line of poetry, he said, someone said it and he did well in what he said. He said, أَصَحُّ مَا قِيلَ بَعْدَ الذِّكْرِ مِنْ خَبَرِ حَدِيثُ خَيْرِ الْبَرَايَا سَيِّدُ الْبَشَرِ. حديث خير البرايا سيد البشري. He said the most correct, the most sound, after al-dhikr, after the remembrance, the Quran, of reports, is the best thing is after the Quran is the hadith of the best of the creation, the master of the humans. أعظم بها, it should be به, هاديا زكاه خالقه بالعدل والفضل والآيات والسور. How great he is, alayhi salatu wassalam, as a guide whom his Lord, his Creator, praised him and sanctified him. He praised him with justice, with excellence, and in the verses and the chapters of the Quran, Allah Azza wa Jal praised his Prophet. فَلَوْ تَمَسَّكَ خَلْقُ اللَّهِ أَجْمَعِهِمْ بِلَفْظَةٍ مِّنْهُ نَالُوا أَشْرَفَ الْوَطَرِ. If all created beings, all creations of Allah, if they hold on, all of them together, to one word of his statements, alayhi salatu wassalam, then they will attain the most noble of objectives. هذا هو العلم والبحر الذي سعدت أو سعدت غواصه بأعلى جوهر الدرر أو بأعالي جوهر الدرر. This is the knowledge, this is the sea, this is the sea whom those who dive in it, the sea of hadith, يعني, those divers who dive in it, they will attain the most of the best, يعني, of the precious pearls, right? Dive in the sea of hadith and you will get the best of the pearls. تشفى الصدور به حقا وخادمه يوم الورود تراه فاز بالصدر. He said that the chests of the people will be healed by it, by the hadith of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, truly. And the one who is a servant, يعني a one who is a servant of the hadith of the Messenger, he will attain on the day of passing, on the bridge, the day of judgment, he will be from those who are going to be from the first and foremost. Those who are going to be in front of others. The one who serves the hadith of the Messenger ﷺ, on the day of judgment, he will be in front of others. In front of others. تلقي ملائكة الرحمن أجنحة له إذا سار هذا أفخر البشر. He said that the angels of the most merciful, they will put down their wings for him when he walks, when he walks to seek the hadith. This is the person, this is the human who should be most proud. يعني the one with the best of pride, or should have the most of pride. As in the authentic hadith, that the angels, they put down their wings for the seeker of knowledge out of them being happy, so happy for the knowledge that he is seeking. So he says, the seeker of the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the angels, they put down their wings for him. This is the best of the people. He should be the best to have pride in what he does, in what he does. يستغفر الله حيتان البحار لمن يرعاه بالفهم لو وقتا من العمر. He said that the fish, the whale, the fish in the sea, they are seeking forgiveness for the one who gives care to the hadith by understanding it, even if he puts in a portion of his time, a portion of his lifetime seeking the hadith, then the angels, the fish, and everything, including the fish in the sea, they will seek forgiveness for him. الفضل لله هذا نور من شرقت له البشائر في الآفاق بالبشر. He said, all the bounty belongs to Allah, but this is the light of the one whom the good news, the glad tidings have risen. يعني good news like the sun, يعني like the sun in the horizon with good news, with glad tidings, right? يعني all bounty belongs to Allah. He gives it to whomever he wills, but this is light. The light, يعني because you are following the statements of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, it's you know, you get the good news as if it is a sun shining in the horizons because of that. صلى عليه إله العرش ما صدحت ورق على فنن الأغصان والشجر. He says, may Allah's salah be on him, the Lord of the throne, or the God of the throne. May Allah say salat on him, or send salat on him, as long as the pigeons continue to make their sound over the branches of the trees, over the branches of the trees. The last line of poetry, and with this we will end today, inshallah. It says, this is the poetry of Abi Bakr al-Qurtubi. He said, and he did well, he said, أحسن وأجاد, when he said, نور الحديث مبين فدن واقتبسي. The light of hadith is manifest and clear, so get closer and take a glimpse. Get closer and take a glimpse. وحد الركاب له نحو الرضا الندسي. أو الندسي. And he said, يعني, you know, the travelers, they used to travel on camels, and the camels, in order to make them go fast, they have someone who rhymes for them. So he says, do this rhyming, and to make them go fast, the camels to go fast, travel towards the praiseworthy, or the source of satisfaction, or the thing that is satisfactory, right? And Nadis, يعني they said they have different meanings for it, but one of the meanings is the water well that is filled of water and it overflew, right? So go towards that, you know, water, that spring of water, that, or that water well that is full of water and it's, you know, overflowing. It says, وَطْلُبْهُ بِالصِّينِ فهو العلم إن رفعت أعلامه برباها يبنى أندلسي. This is now a scholar from the Andalus, the يعني the Islamic Spain, right? He says, seek it, O son of Spain, Andalus, Islamic Spain, seek it even if it be in China. يعني ده حديث اطلبوا العلم ولو في الصين, seek knowledge even if it's in China. This is not a hadith, right? But then he says, seek it even if the distance is far from Spain to China, right? Seek it even if the distance is far as China, for it is the true knowledge if when its flags are raised on its land, O son of Andalus, right? This is the true knowledge, right? يعني the people of Hadith, they need to seek it, even if they had to go to travel far away. فلا تضع في سوى تقييد شارده عمرا عمرا يفوتك بين اللحظ والنفس. He said, do not waste in other than writing down, recording those narrations that are here and there, right? Do not waste your life, because you will miss it. يعني life will finish between a look and a breath that you take, and that's it. You look and you take a breath and خلاص to the grave, right? So don't spend, he says, any time, يعني in other than recording down those ahadith that are spread here and there, right? He said, وَخَلِّ سَمْعَكَ عَنْ بَلْوَى أَخِي جَدَلٍ شُغْلُ اللَّبِيبِ بِهَا ضَرْبٌ مِنَ الْهَوَسِ. Let not your ear, يعني save your ear, abandon, يعني your hearing ability or faculty, let it ignore what? The calamity of the people of arguments, the people of arguments, he said. Because the wise man to be busy with the statements of the people of arguments, this is ضربٌ من الهوسي. This is like some sort of craziness, some sort of foolishness, right? ما إن سمت بأبي بكر ولا عمر ولا أتت عن أبي هر ولا أنسي. Those arguments of the people who argue, this is not something that was seen from Abu Bakr nor Umar. They did not come from Abi Hir, Abu Huraira, nor from Anas. يعني the companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they never got involved in arguments and disputes. He said, إلا هوى وخصومات ملفقة ليست برطب إذا عدت ولا يبسي. يعني those arguments, they are from desires, and they are from disputes and fights between the people of kalam, philosophy. They are, you know, fabricated, right? They are not soft and they are not hard. يعني there is no benefit in it at all. Not soft and not hard. He said, فَلَا يَغُرُّكَ مِنْ أَرْبَابِهَا هَذْرٌ أَجْدَى وَرَبِّكَ مِنْهَا نَغْمَةُ الْجَرَسِ. He said, do not be fooled by the people of those arguments, do not be fooled by their too much talk, you know, their babbling. Basically, they babble too much. يعني we say, oh, mashallah, يعني he's been talking for 2 hours, right? Do not be fooled, do not be deceived by those too much speaking of these arguments, because he said, there is more benefit by Allah, there is more benefit in the sound of the ring, right? The ring tone has more benefit than this too much babbling and talking. He said, أعرهم أذنا صما إذا نطقوا وكن إذا سألوا أو سئلوا تعزى إلى خرسي. He said, if they speak, lend them a deaf ear. If they speak, lend them a deaf ear. And B, if they are asked, or if they ask you, Allah knows which one of them, more likely if they are asked, be someone who is attributed to being someone who is deaf, right? يعني, if they speak, give them a deaf ear. And if, you know, they ask or they are asked, it's as if you cannot hear, so just don't mind them. ما العلم إلا كتاب الله أو أثر يجلو بنوره هداه كل ملتبس. The knowledge is nothing but the book of Allah or a report by the light of its guidance, it will clear everything that is confusing, that is mixed up. نور لمقتبس. It is light for the one who wants to take a glimpse. خير لملتمس. It is goodness for the seeker of the truth. حما لمحترس. It is a protection for the one who is taking precautions. نعمة لمبتئس. It is a favor and a bounty for the one who is at misery. فاعكف ببابهما على طلابهما تمحو العمى بهما عن كل ملتمس. So stay, يعني camp at their doors, the two doors of the book and the sunnah. Camp there and stick or stay there, seeking both of them, seeking to learn the Quran and the sunnah. And by this you will erase, you will take away the blindness from everyone who seeks the truth. He said, ورد بقلبك عذبا من حياضهما تغسل بماء الهدى ما فيه من دنسي. And he said, you should have your heart come to drink from its fresh, from the fresh water of their pools, the pools of the Quran and the Sunnah, the freshest of waters. Have your heart go and drink from there, and you will wash by the water of guidance whatever you have in your heart of dirt and filth. وقف النبي وأتباع النبي يكن أو تكن من هديهم أبدا تدنو إلى قبسي. Follow the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام and the followers of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, and you will have of their guidance forever. You will have from their guidance means to getting closer to taking a glimpse of light. والزم مجالسهم واحفظ مجالسهم واندب مدارسهم بالأربع الدروسي. He said, stick to their sittings. The people who teach the Quran and the Sunnah, stick to them. And also memorize what they say in those sittings. And cry for their schools that have gone and vanished. He said, وَسْلُكْ طَرِيقَهُمُ وَلْزَمْ فَرِيقَهُمُ تَكُنْ رَفِيقَهُمُ فِي حَضْرَةِ الْقُدُسِ. He said, tread their path. Walk on the same path they went upon. وَلْزَمْ فَرِيقَهُمُ. Be with their group. تَكُنْ رَفِيقَهُمُ. You will be amongst their company in paradise, in the presence of the holy place. He said, تلك السعادة إن تلم بساحتها فحط رحلك.